Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Lisa. I'm a 45-year-old single person currently living in the Northern Virginia area. If you're new to my channel, welcome. And if you're returning, thank you so much for stopping back by. I really appreciate it. Today I am going to be stuffing my cash envelopes, and this is going to be for the week of April 24th. As usual, I've got my conscious wallet envelopes that I'm going to be using, and of course, the cash. So let's go ahead and count the money so you guys know how much I'm stuffing this week. 20, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 85, 90. So I'm stuffing $90 this week. All right, let's go ahead and get started. The first category is carpool, and I wasn't going to stuff carpool, but I'm going to go ahead and do this. I took out the $40 that I'd kind of been holding on to in my account for carpool. I got an email from my employer, and it basically said that, you know, soon we're probably going to be transitioning back into the office again. Virginia has a stay-at-home order right now, but with everything going on with the government, it looks like we may be reopening sooner rather than later. And I just want to be prepared that if that happens, that I have some money in my carpool envelope. So I do have a new budget sheet here, and I'm going to go ahead and put the opening balance. We're going to put zero. I'm going to put carpool over here on the left. So the date, and I'm going to put April 24th. I'm going to write that it is a deposit. And I'm going to add $40 because that's what was in here, I think, before. So that gives a balance of $40. So I do have 20 and 40 for carpool. Now, carpool is only, it's $20 per week. When I am writing, I don't know, for those of you that are new here, I live in the Northern Virginia area, so we're real close to Washington, D.C. Traffic is an absolute nightmare, and I have, I'm in a carpool with three other ladies, and the way that the carpool works is that when I am writing, then I pay whoever is driving $5 per day to ride in the carpool. I work from home one day per week, so $20 is what I end up paying per week for carpool. I drive one week per month, and then the ladies who are riding will pay me $5 per day each. So $40 will give me 2 weeks in as the rider, and I think once everything resets, I'll just volunteer to drive, you know, one of those first couple of weeks so that I get my money back and I won't have to replenish this envelope. And then the money just kind of recycles. So when I ride, I take from it. When I'm driving, I put the money straight back into this envelope. So I usually don't have to use any money in my budget for carpool. All right, so that's enough about carpool. Let's go ahead and put the money in the envelope. I don't know if you guys noticed, my setup's a little bit different. I'm working from home, of course, and I've had to use my desk for actual work. All right, let's move into my sinking funds here. Let's start with clothes, and we're going to add $10 to my clothing envelope. So let's see here, right now we should have $30. We're going to add 10. So again, adding the date for 24, adding that it is a deposit. I'm adding $10, and that should give me $40 in this envelope. So let's count it out. So 10, 20, 25, 30, 35, and 40. So $40 in my clothing envelope. Which, after being quarantined, y'all, I may need some bigger pants. Or at least some stretchy pants that have elastic waistbands. I swear I've put on 10 pounds already. So definitely need the extra money for clothes. All right, next is gifts. And gifts is going to get $10. So let's see. Go ahead and add that over here. So I did have $30 as of the last stuffing. So we'll write the date 24th, write that it is a deposit. Adding $10 should give me $40 in gifts. And I've got 10, 20, 30, and 40. So $40 is what I have in here. I usually give $20 for birthdays, so this will be nice. I have a couple birthdays coming up. All right, next is medical. And I think, did I say medical was going to get stuffed? I don't know that it is. Let me look at my, no, medical is not going to get stuffed. Now, I had found some money last week when I was spring cleaning, and I went ahead and stuffed that money in medical, but I'm not going to stuff this week. So I do have, as a last stuffing, $23 in medical. We'll just count it, make sure all the money is here. So I've got 10, 20, 21, 22, 23. So $23, which medical I don't use very often. I think probably whatever accumulates in here, I'll probably end up using to get some new glasses. All right, I have $30 left to stuff, and let's see what envelopes I've got left. I stuffed Christmas last week, so I'm not going to stuff that this week, because I'm pretty sure I was able to do the full 20, and I did $20, and that's what my budget was. And just in case you guys didn't watch my last video, so for 2 weeks my budget was $20 for Christmas, and that's what I ended up stuffing. Last week was 20 to give me $40, and I'm just not gonna stuff that again this week. So go ahead and close that up. Let's see here what to stuff. So I've got beauty, and I'm pretty sure beauty was fully funded. Yes, I think it was. Right, so I put $10 last week in beauty, and that has still $35, which is what is on my card. I'm not going to stuff this again, but just to show you guys that the money that should be in there is in there, because I sometimes am bad about taking money out of one envelope, but not this time. So beauty. Let's see here. Gas for my car. Still, y'all, I have more than a half tank of gas. I put $25 in there on the 3rd, and it is still in here. Actually, I think this may have even, maybe before the 3rd. I don't know. It's the 24th, and I still have all my money in here, so $25 in gas. I think what is in my gas tank will probably last me another month if we're still working from home. So gas is not going to be something that I contribute to. All right. So I've got Fur Babies Vet and spending. I still have $30. I need to figure out what I'm going to do with this money. Maybe I'll add, I don't think I need spending, because let's look at my spending envelope. Right, I have $26 in here still. 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. I don't think I need to add anything to spending, so let's leave this alone. And y'all, I did not really plan this out. It's only like, I don't know, 5:30 in the morning on a work day. I got up at 4, bright-eyed and bushy-tailed, and I was sitting here drinking my coffee, and I thought, you know what, I'm going to go ahead and stuff my envelopes now. So this was not a well-thought-out plan. So I have $30, so let's do $10 for Fur Babies Vet, and let's go ahead and put another 20 into Christmas. That sounds like a good idea. So let me put my notes aside here. Sometimes that's just the way it goes. It's early in the morning. I was feeling froggy and no plan. All right, so Christmas has 40 in it. Let's add another 20. like to have some money at the end of the year for gifts. So $20, so that'll give me $60 in my Christmas envelope. So 20, 40, 50, and 60. I've been thinking about my emergency fund. I have $1,000 in the bank, and I think I'm gonna pull that money out and put it in an envelope so I can count it every week. I don't know what you guys do with your emergency fund, but I think that I need to just count it every week, which I know I've got a safe in my house. It's fireproof. That I can keep the money in, so I'm not worried about it being stolen or, you know, burning up in a fire. So I think I'm going to do that. My next paycheck when I go to the bank is go ahead and take that money out so I can count it. All right, back to the vet. It is $424. I'm going to write that it is a deposit. I'm adding $10, and that gives me $30 for fur babies. And so 10, 20, and 30. I did put in my Walmart grocery pickup order for my groceries, because I'm not actually doing groceries or food for babies and household items. I usually would stuff them, but I'm not doing that now because I've been doing the Walmart grocery pickup, and my pickup order is exactly what my budget is. I think I might have a little bit less in my pickup order, which is good. I'm finding that it's helping to keep me on track as far as like how much I'm spending in groceries. I'm anticipating that some of the items won't be available and probably will have a little bit of money extra. So we'll see how that goes. But that is everything, guys. Those are my cash envelopes for the week of April 24th. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope you have a great day or night wherever you're at. Bye.